You hear that sound? You see those raindrops? Rain is so pretty, right? It's a great a relaxing time. If you're out on the porch during a spring rain, it was warm and it cooled off. That dry air from the big thunderhead comes through. It can be just so fun. But in this case, it has stopped raining outside, and this rain is inside the building here at 2712 Lake Street Laundry World, where you can get all your clothes washed clean. And also the intergalactic offices of the cityshouldbedifferent.com right over there. And my name is Paul Pettifer, and what we're witnessing here is something that's been broken, right? So the Hurricane Laura winds came and swept the roof right off this building, and now we've tarped the building, but it's a flat roof, so tarps are, you know, not very, I mean, they just can't do the job, right? They can't seal. They can probably keep the water off of a mist, but if it's a downpour, well, then the water is going to come through in various places. Not every place. The tarp keeps it away from some. It comes over others. But so it's a patchwork. And when Adam and Eve sinned in the garden, right, what God had made without sin, that's the creation, man and woman, sin entered their life. And it broke them, and their hearts were broken. And ever since then, that God was setting forth his plan, and he started with a patchwork, right? He actually slew an animal and made a covering for their nakedness. They were ashamed, and so an animal paid the price, and God made a covering for them. That was the first prototype of, or the road to remedy, right? The ultimate remedy comes when God sent his son, Jesus Christ, to pay the penalty that Adam and Eve and you and me owed for our sin. And that means that we don't have to keep putting patches over things, right? The Old Testament system that the Jews did of I'll just walk around a little bit. You can kind of see the inside of the building here. There's rain all around. So the Old Testament systems of Adam and Eve, after Adam and Eve sinned, they set up the Jewish nation, the tabernacle, then ultimately the temple with sacrifice and all these religious systems and these manifest miracles, the supernatural deliverance from Egypt that millions of people saw, this hand of God deliverance. And yet it wasn't enough, right? There's something broken in us that takes God to intervene in our lives. And that's what he did when he sent Jesus, right? All the Old Testament story was leading up to the apex to say, even the perfect religious system, something fell over there, is not enough. You need the God of heaven to intervene and take away my heart of stone and grant me a heart of flesh. And that's what Jesus did when he paid the price on Calvary for someone else's sin. That's mine and yours. He laid in the ground, fully dead, right, for 3 days. And on the third day, Sunday morning, he took his life back, and he says, if anyone puts their trust in me, I'll give them my life, his life, he says. And so when I look at broken things like a roof that's supposed to hold water on the outside, not let it in, but now it's failed and we have a tarp covering it, and it's not going to work. So that's how it looks for you and me when we try to get to holiness, get to peace, get to fulfillment without God. It looks just like a tarp roof, and there's stuff all in here, right? We have buckets for water all in here. This is a spare bucket, but there's a bucket there. There's a bucket on top of there. There's a big bucket on the other end. It's completely dark over there, so I'm not going to go over there and fall down. And it fills up with water and it overflows. So we can put tarps on our sin. We can put buckets in. There's water all over the floor, right? It's raining right in the entranceway, on the inside of the door, right? That's not how it's supposed to be. We could try to do that in our lives and make a way to be right, be spiritual without God or without the Son of God, God's ultimate provision for us. But it's through Jesus that God has fully shown his own willingness to bring us back. Right? He wants people close to him, and he'll do whatever it takes to get there. In the middle of Hurricane Laura, I just don't want to miss my shot at sharing with everybody I know and everybody I don't know that God loves you, and the brokenness that we feel, it's real for sure. Hurricane Laura, pain is real, right? All these storm shredded things that weren't meant to be shredded, like trees and roofs, and it's very disruptive, right? It's disruptive for you and me, right? I'm paying for things that I shouldn't or I don't normally do, and you're doing the same, and we're out serving in neighbors, right, in the way that makes Jesus smile. I think when we're loving our neighbors, we're our crew, and we're cooking for people, and so you're doing the same. You're helping put tarps on people's roofs and all that, and God is always communicating his love to us. So today I'll give you one. I called what I thought was my friend Brian Williams. I was looking through phone numbers. I'm on my AT&T phone because my Sprint phone doesn't work. And I normally have his name. And I called and I thought it was Brian. It was the guy who did the tarps on this building. And I was trying to find my friend because I needed some help. He goes, "Oh, you need help? Me and my guys, we need something to do." And I'm like, "Well, come on over." And like that, we took all of the fallen roof out of this building, or the ceiling fell, smelling bad. It was terrible. So we got all that done before this rain came, the first part. There's some that's actually held better, and we're going to peel it off in the morning. God provided for me, right? I was calling for help, and I called someone else, and I ended up accidentally calling the guy God provided. So he's going to provide for you too, and maybe it's this video that's going to help you see that. Man, I need to reconsider who Jesus is. Maybe you're like me, and I thought I knew who Christ was. I went to Catholic school, and I did this and that, and then somebody had to take me by the hand and befriend me and share the good news about Jesus. So this Sunday night in the backyard at Paul's Rib Shack, we're gonna share worship time, singing songs about God. We're gonna share something out of the scriptures. We're gonna hear from a few people who've seen God's handiwork in their life this week in the middle of all this chaos, all this pain in the neck, this tragedy, really. People's homes, all their stuff gone, your income, people's we already did coronavirus, right? Business is down, and now we have Hurricane Laura, business is down. In the middle of all that, God's at work. He's not forgotten you. So if you want to, you can come hang out with us Sunday night at the backyard. And I'll be praying for you, and I love you. And the broken things aren't the way it should be. God knows that. He stepped out of eternity, right? He stepped away from the inside of our building where the rain is on the inside, right? Because we've made little patchworks to try to figure it out on our own, and it just doesn't work. And he knows all that. He's reaching out to you right now to tell you how much he loves you. And I can't wait to see you soon, and hope that my life is an expression to you of how much Jesus loves you. My name is Paul Pettifer, and since Jesus is alive, then all the way from Gosport to Greywood, the city should be different. It's not supposed to rain on the inside. And it won't. It won't forever. God loves you. He's here to fix everything that's broken. Jesus is alive.